and welcome to another episode of Movie Spoiler Alerts. Today we're talking about the 2014 film, Divergent, which has another film coming out in the series in March, so hopefully this summary will get you ready for the next film. The film takes place in futuristic Chicago, where society has been divided into five factions. The first is Abnegation, the selfless government who always wears simple gray clothing. The second faction is Amnesty, who provides the food, values peace, and always wears red or orange. The third faction is Candor, who are honest and judge for truth, and wear white. The fourth faction is the Dauntless, the brave protectors, who wear black and oftentimes have tattoos. The final faction is Erudite, the intellectual faction who wears blue. The remaining population is considered factionless, which are essentially the homeless of the society. At the age of 16, children in the society go through a drug-induced psychological test in which they determine which is the proper faction for them, and that is decided at the choosing ceremony. The film follows Beatrice Pryor, who is born into Abnegation. Her mother and father work for the government, alongside the head of Abnegation, Marcus Eaton. Beatrice also has a brother named Caleb. Beatrice takes her faction test, and it is revealed that she has equal attributes for multiple factions, which means she is considered divergent. She has traits for the selfless Abnegation, the intellectual Erudite, and the brave Dauntless. Beatrice's proctor tells her to keep these mixed results a secret, as the divergent are considered uncontrollable threats to the government, and are often eliminated. The next day at the choosing ceremony, Beatrice's brother Caleb chooses to go to join the intellectual Erudite, and Beatrice chooses to join the Dauntless. Beatrice meets up with the other Dauntless initiates, where they travel to the Dauntless headquarters. After Beatrice arrives and performs a feat of bravery by jumping off a tall building into a pit, she decides to shorten her name to just Triss. Triss and the other initiates begin their training for becoming members of the Dauntless, which has become exceptionally grueling during the first phase. Only the best of the initiates will become members, and those that don't make it will become factionless, essentially homeless. Triss makes some friends amongst the initiates, but also has some enemies, primarily an initiate named Peter, who even tries to kill her at one point. There are two senior Dauntless members that oversee their training. The first is Four, a tough but kind Dauntless, who Triss develops feelings for. And the second is Eric, a brutal and ruthless leader of the Dauntless. Triss passes through the first phase of her training, after winning a capture the flag game, and moves on to the second phase, where initiates will undergo serum-induced simulations of their greatest fears. Triss, however, is able to breeze through the simulations, drastically quicker than the other initiates. The reason is because she is a divergent, and because she is a divergent, serums don't work the same for her as they do for other initiates. Four takes notice of this, however, and warns her that she needs to hide her powers, so she isn't persecuted for being a divergent. Four and Triss begin to develop a romantic relationship, and Four reveals that his real name is Tobias Eaton, and is the son of the leader of the Abnegation, Marcus Eaton, who used to abuse Four when he was much younger. Triss visits her brother Caleb, who informs her that Erudite is planning to overthrow Abnegation in order to take over the government. Triss returns to the Dauntless headquarters, completes her final test, and becomes a full member of the Dauntless. Afterwards, all the Dauntless are given a new serum that they are told is for tracking purposes. However, it is really a mind control serum. The next day, the Dauntless are activated, and the mind-controlled Dauntless are sent to attack and execute the Abnegation faction, under the control of the leaders of the Dauntless and the Erudite. Triss, and any other Divergent, are unaffected by the serum, however, as their divergent ways makes them immune to the effects of the serum. Triss, however, blends into the mind-controlled Dauntless, and eventually discovers that Four is also a Divergent, and isn't being controlled. The Dauntless arrive where the Abnegation are, and begin killing innocent Abnegation faction members. Triss and Four are found to be sentient, and Four is put into custody by Eric, and Triss is ordered to be executed. Triss's mother, however, saves Triss, but eventually, her mother is shot and killed. Triss finds her father, brother, and Four's father, Marcus. The group sneaks into the Dauntless headquarters, and fights through several mind-controlled Dauntless members, including some initiates and friends she knew, and eventually, Triss encounters Peter, the rival initiate who tried to kill her. Peter is not mind-controlled, but Triss is able to defeat Peter and uses him to take them to the control room in order to deactivate the mind-controlled Dauntless. Triss's father is killed on the way, and Triss travels in alone to find that 4 is under the control of a much more powerful mind control agent, and 4 attacks Triss. Eventually, Triss is able to break 4's trance, and they find that the leader of the Erudite, Janine, is going to have the Dauntless Army execute all of the Abnegation faction. They stop her and are able to deactivate all of the Dauntless, saving the Abnegation faction just in time. The group escapes the compound, knowing that war has only just begun. So that was the spoilers for Divergent. If you have another film you'd like to see me spoil, please let me know in the comments below. Check out movie spoiler alerts on our various forms of social media, and remember to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching.